on board the 14th Vega launcher since it entered service 7 years ago. And as we've heard, it's flight number 14, VV14. That means Vol Vega 14. We have three launch vehicles here at the Guiana Space Center. Vega's the baby of the family. She stands 30 meters tall. She weighs in at 138 tons. Take a look at the top of the vehicle. Inside there is our satellite. We call this pointy top of the vehicle the fairing. That's what PRISMA looks like. And as we said earlier, really, this is an all-Italian launch because we're orbiting an Italian satellite built by an Italian, the Italian prime contractors OHB Italia and Leonardo Space and Airborne Systems on behalf of the Italian Space Agency, ASI. And it's all travelling on board a rocket conceived, designed and built by the Italian prime contractor Avio, who leads a consortium of European industries all working together. That's what I call teamwork. Now, this is the Mission Control Center, and on the right is not the real Ariane 5. It is a model, a near life-size model, but not quite as big as the real thing. And inside that building we saw, this is the Mission Control Center and the operational teams focusing hard. Now, at this point before the launch, now, as Luce said, the final countdown started just over 9 hours ago. And during that time, there were various major moments. The onboard computer was activated at L, if we say L is launch, L minus 4 hours and 40 minutes. The mobile gantry withdrew 3 hours and 15 minutes before launch. And the entire system was ready at minus 50 minutes. Now we're coming up to the next important milestone.
À tous de DDO, attention pour la séquence finale lanceur. Top I0 moins 4 minutes.
And the range operations manager has announced the beginning of the synchronized sequence. This is the automated sequence. The computers are now controlling all the final checks in the countdown. They manage an impressive list of operations. And all of those systems across the base send information about their health status to these panels, which we can see on the right side of your screen. And we call them the status panels. They are showing us the status of three main systems: the rocket and pad, the range, and the satellite. The range is the name we give to the spaceport. The base here is about 750 kilometers squared, and that also includes the tracking stations, which are downrange of the spaceport. Now, we have a couple of control centers. Obviously, we've been looking at mission control, which is in charge of the whole mission. This is the launch control center. These teams are in charge of everything to do with the launcher and the pad. And then we have a number of different teams working in here, but primarily one of them is responsible for the operations on the ground, coordinating with mission control for authorization to launch. And everything, if everything goes according to plan, they're the team who trigger the automated sequence. And then the other team is responsible for the flight readiness of the vehicle, overseeing all the operations from assembly of the launcher to the moment of launch. We have quality teams as well, working alongside them, making sure that everybody is adhering to the strict set of procedures. And they're based in a blockhouse, protected blockhouse, which is about a couple of kilometers from this pad. So they're very close to the pad. They're watching over all this final phase of the synchronized sequence. We're 1 minute now and 37 seconds to launch. Here are all the VIP guests who you saw inside the Mission Control Center are now coming outside onto the terraces outside to go and watch the launch with their own eyes rather than watching it on the screens here.
À tous les DDO, attention pour moins une minute.
Coming up to the 1 minute mark.
Top I zero moins une minute.
And we have 1 minute to launch. Time to say our very best wishes to everybody who's worked so hard for today, to the PRISMA teams, the Industrial Consortia, led by OHB Italia and Leonardo, the Italian Space Agency, the operational teams, who are waiting to fly their satellite once it's separated, to CNES, ESA, ArianeSpace, and of course to all of you who are watching us on the internet. Good luck, everybody, for the launch.
À tous les DDO, attention pour le décompte final. Dix, neuf, huit, sept, six, cinq, quatre, trois, deux, un, top. Allumage P80, décollage V14 Prisma. Propulsion nominale. Propulsion nominale. Acquisition de la télémesure par la station de Saint-Jean. Pilotage calme, propulsion nominale.
And they are off. Prisma has started its journey. Vega blazing a trail across the night sky here in the skies over the Guiana Space Center. The Vega launcher takes its name from the brightest star in the galaxy of constellation of Lyra. Fifth brightest star in the night sky, and tonight she is lighting up our night sky. Heading north now over the Atlantic.
Séparation P80.
And we can see the separation there of the first stage.
Allumage Z23.
And he's telling us that the second stage is switching on the Z23. This is what we're looking at now.
Propulsion Z23 nominal.
He's telling us that the propulsion of the engine is nominal. And there's the beginning of the dog leg maneuver. The dog leg maneuver is taking us out towards the north because we've been flying rather like an aeroplane. When it takes off, it has to go on a certain trajectory because it comes off the, I was about to say launch pad, but the runway, of course. And then depending on which direction it's going in, it turns and flies in that direction. And that's what the dog leg is. We have turned
trajectoire nominal, paramètres à bord nominaux.
Towards the north, and he's telling us that everything is going normally. Top right-hand side of the screen is our trajectory. The cross is the actual position of the launcher.
Leg, paramètres nominaux.
End of the dog leg maneuver, and all the parameters are normal, he says. And you could see just at the bottom of the screen there, we'll be seeing it again. There we go. Our altitude, 134 kilometers above our planet, on the bottom left of the screen. In the middle, our distance. That's the distance from the pad if you were to draw a straight line from the pad across the Earth to the position where the launcher is over.
Séparation Z23.
On the right, the speed, and now confirmation of the separation of the Z23 stage. Burnt its fuel, we don't need it anymore. There's a few seconds.
Z9.
Now we have a confirmation of the
séparation de la coiffe.
Z9 is now switched on, and the engine, the fairing, has now been
nominal.
Jettisoned. The propulsion, he says, is nominal. So we don't need the fairing anymore. It was protecting our satellite from the rigors of the launch. It was protecting us from friction. It was protecting us from the acoustic vibrations at liftoff. I'm sure you can imagine just how loud that is, or was. And so we are officially in space. This is what it looked like. We lifted off from the pad 4 minutes and 40 seconds ago.
Tous les paramètres à bord sont nominaux.
From the pad, you can see it there in the Guiana Space Center on the northeastern coast of South America. Galileo is the tracking station at the Guiana Space Center. Vega shot into the sky.
Fin de mission sauvegarde.
Shot into the sky, and it was a beautiful launch. We managed to see it all the way until the separation of the first stage. So that we were very, very lucky. And this is a simulation of those predictions. So a simulation of what exactly what's been planned for the flight. It's great because it means we can visualize it. We can see what it looks like up there.
Separation Z9.
And we have separation of the Z9. Z for Zefiro, a kind of wind. An Italian wind, a little bit like the Sirocco or the Mistral. So, third stage has switched off its engine. The main propulsion phase of the flight is now over. And we are picking up the signal at the tracking station in Bermuda, an island in the Caribbean, and correct me if I'm wrong, I think the tracking station's actually on Cooper's Island, which is just to the east of Bermuda. In fact, the teams at the Bermuda tracking station have been a long time space partner, dating back actually to the NASA days of the first manned space program. That was called Mercury, late 1950s and early 60s. And then, of course, as well with the Apollo Lunar Program in the 1960s. It has two sets of monopropellant thrusters.
Separation Prisma.
Role and attitude. And he has confirmed that we have separation of the Prisma satellite, and that's what it looks like. The satellite is pushed away by a set of springs. It is pinged into space, all very carefully planned for collision avoidance. And this is good news. Italy has a new satellite. Our warmest congratulations. Our warmest congratulations to the PRISMA teams, to the Italian Space Agency, the Industrial Consortia, led by OHB Italia and Leonardo. Well done, everybody.